Hello students, welcome to this CET class. Today I'll be discussing multiple choice questions on the chapter atomic structure and periodic properties, that is from first year PUC. So let's consider the questions one by one. Atoms of element A and element B having same mass number but different atomic number. You know, an element is represented as XZA, where A is the number of neutrons plus number of protons, and Z is known as atomic number, that is nothing but number of protons. So if two elements have same mass number and different atomic number, let's see what are the options given: isobars, isotopes, isotones, and isomers. See, isomers is not the answer. It refers to compounds having different structure but same formula. Maybe inorganic compounds like coordination compounds, or they may be organic compounds. Now let's see the definition of isobars. Isobars are the substances which are having same mass number. Actually, that is the answer for this. So isobars are the atoms of different elements. Vere elements do atom aagutte. Say X is an element, say A is an element, B is an element. So their A value, mass number will be same, but Z value will be different. Then they are called isobars, and that is the actually answer for this question also. Isotopes you are familiar with. Say 6 carbon 12, 6 carbon 13, 6 carbon 14, they are isotopes. See, isotopes, as you can see, they are having same atomic number, number of protons is same, but mass number is different. That means number of nucleons is different. Isotones refer to the isotopes having same number of neutrons. So they are isotopes of different elements having same number of neutrons. So we shall consider the examples in the next few questions. So answer for this question: atoms of different elements having same mass number but different atomic number or isobars. Probably bar refers to something like mass, gravity, weight. Therefore, mass number same means it is isobar. Okay, next question. A specific isotope has atomic number 18 and mass number 35. How many electrons are there? So there is an element, say X, which is having an atomic number 18, mass number 35. Now what does this 18 represent? That is the number of protons. Number of protons in an atom will be same as number of electrons. Electrons may change if it is an ion, but is an atom, then it will be same. So 35 minus 18 is the number of electrons. Number of protons and number of electrons are same. Therefore, that will be the answer. So number of neutrons is the, then you have to give it 35 minus 18. So that answer will be number of neutrons. So number of neutrons will carry, that is 17. So it is number of electrons. Next question. So the species 24 chromium 3 plus, so it's an ion, it is not an atom, contains how many protons, neutrons and electrons? See, 24 is the number of protons, so there is no doubt in it, it is the number of protons. Then 52 minus 24 will be number of neutrons, so how much it comes to? So it is about 28 neutrons, so number of neutrons is 28. Cannot say number of protons is same as number of electrons, because there is 3 plus charge, 3 electrons are removed. That means 24 minus 3, 21 electrons must be there. So this species contains 24 protons, 28 neutrons and 21 electrons. Therefore, D will be the answer. Question number 4. The fundamental particles present in equal numbers in an atom. So equal number in an atom will be number of electrons and protons. So it's a very simple question. Neutron number goes on changing. For first few elements, number of neutrons may appear to be same, but later on number of neutrons becomes very much excess. Then we say it is a heavy nucleus and it becomes radioactive. So here for an atom, it will be same number of protons and electrons. Which set of the following nucleides? Okay, this is which set of following nucleides represents isotopes? See, this one A, H, same mass number, 1, D2, same mass, same atomic number, different mass number, tritium. See, it is the hydrogen is the special element where isotopes are given different names like deuterium, tritium, like that. Even they can write it as 1H2 and 1H3 also. So atomic number of protons is same, number of neutrons were either. So actually A is the answer for this, that is they are isotopes. So second one you can observe, 40 is the mass number for both argon and calcium. They are differing in the number of protons, 18 and 20. So second one is the example of isobars. See, B is the example of isobars. In C, you can see there are atoms of different elements, oxygen and nitrogen. They are having different atomic number, different mass number also. But if you subtract the mass number and atomic number, you get number of neutrons. So number of neutrons in oxygen 16 isotope, that will be 8. And again in nitrogen also it is 8. That means they are having same number of neutrons. So C is an example of isotones. See, C is isotones. Similarly, D also appears to be same. So whatever be the number of neutrons in silicon 30 isotope, so that will be same in case of phosphorus also. So you can see they both are having 60 number of neutrons. So D is also isotones. So B is isobar, C and D are isotones. So A is the example. ಏನಲ್ಲಿ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಗೆ ಕಂಡಿಡಿಯಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ವೆರಾಸ್ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಐಸೋಬಾರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐಸೋಟೋನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ದೇ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು 23 ಈಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 11 ಈಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಸ್ So if you subtract, you get 12. So there are 12 neutrons, 11 protons. So, and there should be 11 electrons also. Number of electrons is also 11. So do we have the answer here? 12 neutrons and 11 protons. So C is the answer. Watermelon model of an atom. Now we come to the atomic models. Watermelon model of an atom is also called Thomson's atomic model. Thomson, who experimented with cathode rays and anode rays, he discovered E by M ratio of the anode rays and cathode rays. So on that basis, he proposed the watermelon model or pudding model of an atom. So what he says, atom is a holosphere. No, it is not. It's wrong. Atom is similar to solar system. It was not proposed by Thomson. A sphere of electrons with protons on the surface. No, it is not that. A sphere of protons in which the electrons are embedded here and there. So he proposed the pudding model where he says protons are in the form of a sphere and electrons are fixed here and there. So here and there will be electrons embedded here and there on the surface. Therefore, it is called pudding model. So it is the sphere of protons, not sphere of electrons. Therefore, it is D that is the answer for this question. The cathode ray tube experiments proposed by J.J. Thomson demonstrated what? Cathode rays are stream of positively charged ions. You know that it is actually stream of negatively charged ions. The ratio of charge to mass particle of cathode rays varies from different gases. No, it is not correct. See, in case of cathode rays, so there will be two electrodes, anode and cathode, connected to very high voltage, like 10,000 volt source, and a gas will be there at very low pressure conditions, like 1 mm mercury. So there will be rays traveling from cathode to anode. So charge to mass ratio is same for different gases. So if you place hydrogen or helium or neon or sodium vapor, so whatever the gas that is placed, different gases show same E by M ratio for cathode rays. Therefore, he concluded that the particles of cathode rays are common for every atom, and it is called electron. So it is different, varies as Anta put it. So the second statement is wrong. Cathode rays are streams of negatively charged ions. That is also correct statement. So really, no statement is not an erdu sariyadi anta. E by M, charge to mass ratio of electrons is about 1800 times larger than the charge to mass ratio of H plus ion, or that is the simplest anode ray particle. See, anode rays are nothing but the positively charged particles which travel from anode to cathode. So if it is positively charged particle, then it will be the positively charged ion produced by the gas. So E by M of say proton is equal to E by M 1800 into mass of electron, because protons are 1800 times heavier than electrons. Now if I cross multiply 1800, if I take that to the left side, 1800 into charge to mass ratio of the proton is equal to charge to mass ratio of the electron. So charge to mass ratio of the electron is 1800 times, it is correct, 1800 times larger than charge to mass ratio of a proton. So there are two correct points here, both C and D. So both are correct, both are answers. So in that case, you will be given much more options like A only, B only, both C and D. So you will be given some more options further. So there are two statements regarding the Thomson's experiments. That is C and D, both are the answers. Which of the following is true? Neutron is as heavy as proton. So this is almost correct. The neutron and proton mass differ in a very, very small quantity. The difference is very much negligible because it is the order of 10 to the minus 27 kg, and both start with 1.67 almost. Therefore, they are nearly same. First statement is correct. Electron is 1800 times heavier than proton. Actually, it is lighter than proton, 1800 times. Therefore, second statement is wrong. Protons and neutrons have same kind of charge. You know, neutrons are actually neutral, electrically neutral particles. Therefore, C is also wrong. Electrons are positively charged and that is also wrong. So the correct statement is neutron is as heavy as proton. So that will be the answer for this question A. Dash rays were used by gold foil experiment conducted by Rutherford. So it is called alpha ray scattering experiment. Alpha rays produced by some radioactive elements like polonium were used. So answer for this question is alpha rays. Alpha rays were thrown against a very thin gold foil, and then deflections were observed by Rutherford. That led to Rutherford's atomic model. So it is called actually alpha ray scattering experiment. Therefore, answer for this question will be C. The deflection of alpha particles passing through the thin foil. See, when There is a thin foil, alpha ray particles are thrown against it. Some alpha ray particles are scattered in different angles. So that scattering is nothing but deflection from the zero angle. Should have traveled like this with zero deflection. But if they are scattered by some angle, then we say it is deflection. Then why it happens? It happens because of the repulsion from the nucleus. Nucleus is also positively charged. Alpha ray particles are also positively charged. It is nothing but helium nucleus or helium ion, helium 2 plus ion. So they are also positively charged particles. So they are repelled by nucleus. Therefore, they are scattered in different angles. So electrostatic repulsion from the nucleus is the answer. So A is the answer. Collision of the nucleus causes them to go backwards. So vapors 180 degree deflection are there. Then we say it is collision. Interaction with the electrons almost does not happen because electrons are far away from the nucleus. So it is not attraction of the nucleus agala because alpha ray particles and nucleus must be identically charged. So this is a point that is giving rise to the conclusion that nucleus must be positively charged particle. That is according to Rutherford's model. So A is the answer for this question. Because of the observation made that some alpha particles are directed gold foil scattered backwards 180 degree centigrade, he was able to conclude that. So just now I said some alpha ray particles, very rare, almost in 1 in 10,000 particles come back after colliding against the gold foil. So he concluded that nucleus is the heaviest part of the atom. So that is the answer for this. So this is the another postulate of Rutherford's atomic model. See, nucleus is so heavy, alpha ray particles are also heavy particles compared to beta particles and gamma rays. But they are coming back after colliding against some particle, means it must be very, very heavy. So that is the conclusion drawn from it. Positively charged part of the atom occupy very small fraction volume of the atom. It is because of many alpha particles pass through without any deflection. So almost all 99% of the alpha particles go through without any deflection. That led to the conclusion that nucleus must be very small compared to atom itself. So answer for this question is B. D, electrons are the part of the matter. It is actually conclusion from the Thomson's experiments, not from Rutherford's experiment. Difference between anode ray and cathode ray particles is that they have same E by M ratio. Option A is wrong. See, E by M ratio depends on the charge of the ion, like helium has 2 plus or hydrogen has single plus, sodium ions have Na plus. So it depends on the charge of the ion or the nucleus of the ion. Anode ray particles are same for different gases. Well, actually, they are different for different gases, anode ray particles. So they are the ions, not electrons. Cathode ray particles are a stream of positively charged particles at the particle. That is wrong. Cathode ray particles are common to different gases used in the experiment. So actually, that is the conclusion. So that is the answer. So it is other way of giving the question that we discussed earlier. Which of the following rays have longest wavelength? So it is the electromagnetic spectrum. So where the wavelength goes on increasing. You know, it stretches from cosmic rays, then gamma rays, then comes X-rays, then UV, then visible, then infrared, microwave, and then radio waves. So wavelength goes on increasing. So radio waves must be having longest wavelength, whereas in the given options, X-rays must be having shortest wavelength. Therefore, answer for this question will be radio waves. So shortest wavelength or highest frequency, X-ray. there is some jumble. Okay, some question number missing. Okay, wave theory of light explains what? So wave theory of light explains the D, diffraction and interference of light, that is the Young's double slit experiment, where you study interference of light leading to bright and dark fringes, diffraction, reflection, refraction. All these are explained by considering the wave theory of light. So what wave theory of light did not explain are ABC, black body radiation, line spectra of atoms, photoelectric effect. They were not explained by wave theory. Therefore, the particle theory of light came into being, light as a photon. So actually answer for this question is what it could explain: diffraction, interference, similarly reflection and refraction. 17th question. Okay, your mass is 100 kg and you are traveling with the velocity 1 kilometer per second. Okay, 1 kilometer per second you are traveling. So what is your wavelength? So it is lambda equals h over me de Broglie's equation. So h value is not given, so let's substitute as h itself. Mass is 100 kg, kilogram is the SI unit, multiplied by velocity 1 into 1000 meter per second, because you have to write the SI unit here. So if it is taken first and some units get cancelled, then it will be h into 10 to the power of minus 5 meter. So all other units get cancelled. So it should be in length. So lambda will be in meter. H into 10 to the power of minus 5 meter means this is the answer. So that is your wavelength. This is on the de Broglie's matter wave theory. Which of the following statements on the square of the atomic wave function? You know, the psi is the solution for Schrodinger wave equation. Schrodinger wave equation defines electron as a wave on the basis of certain theories like uncertainty principle and dual nature of matter. And psi square should give us the probability of finding the electron. So let's see what are the options given. Square of the atomic wave function may be positive, negative or imaginary. So that is not correct. Actually psi square will be always positive. Psi may be having an imaginary function. Therefore it is actually square. Psi square is proportional to electron density. That is correct. See, if you draw what are called contour diagrams, you find that the dots are very dense around nucleus, very close to nucleus, then they become less denser as we go away from the nucleus. But it may be found even at the infinite distance in the universe. So psi square is proportional to the electron density. That is correct statement. It is directly proportional to the probability of finding the electron. So electron density indicates the probable region of finding the electron around nucleus. So adu elli thick agirutte, where the dots are very thickly placed, very closely placed, then there will be more density. So C is correct. Psi square equal to the probability of finding the electron if psi is a normalized wave function. That is psi na now simple aga helbeku andre, it is like x plus iy in mathematics, where I is square root of minus 1. So ಈಗ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಸೈ ವಿತ್ ಸೈ ಕಾಂಜುಗೇಟ್. ಅವಾಗ ನೀವು ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರೋ ಅದೇ ಥರ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಐ ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಐ ವೈ, ವೇರ್ ದಿ ಸೈ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿ ಕಾಂಜುಗೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಶ್ರೋಡಿಂಗರ್ ವೇವ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೇವ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಐ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ತೆಗಿಯೋಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ಸೈ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಗೀವ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಫೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಸೈ ಆಸ್ ಎ ನಾರ್ಮಲೈಸ್ ವೇವ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 90% ಆಫ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ನಿಯರ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಟು ಎ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ನಾಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದರೆ ಎ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್. because it will be always positive. Psi square will be always positive value. Only 90% of the quote, even that will be correct. Psi square is equal to the probability of finding the electron. Now orbital anta heltivala, that is the most probable region, that is 90% of psi square we have to take. So idralli onde one option wrong agiradu A. Idu negative agiralla, imaginary agiralla. Question number 19, energy difference between the two orbits of hydrogen for Lyman series. Okay, it is about Lyman series. When electron jump to the ground state, n equals 1 state, from higher orbits we get the line spectrum of hydrogen. So line spectrum of hydrogen, and the first we get Lyman series. Lyman series appears in UV region where the frequencies are very high, so energy of the wave produced is also very high. Short wavelength, high frequency waves. So n equals 1, n equals 2, 3, 4 in the electrons must transit. Therefore, answer for this question is actually A. So itara now we ask series bekaru question na kelbodu Lyman series ke n1 equals 1. 20th question, say similar question is for passion series. See, we get different series depending on say n1 equals what and n2 equals what. N1 is 1, n2 is 2, 3, 4, then we say it is Lyman series. Balmer series appears in the visible region. That was the one first discovered. I can recognize another than n1 equals 2 and n2 will be 3, 4, 5. Then comes the fashion series where n1 is 3. So electrons are falling into the third orbit. So n equals 3 orbit, the electrons fall from 4, 5, 6, etc. So fashion series, and n2 will be 4, 5, 6, etc. So you know infrared region. So infrared region close to the visible, that's called near infrared region. So answer for this question will be C. Then comes bracket and fan series. For bracket series, n1 is 4. Electrons fall from higher orbits, 5, 6, 7 orbits to 4. And then fan series where to the 5th orbit electrons fall from 6, 7, 8, etc. So ili fashion series kottidare bracket anta kottidare nodi idu bracket series D is actually bracket series. There is one more series which is named after US Army Navy officer that comes in the radio wave region. The radius of first Bohr orbit in an hydrogen is, the radius of first Bohr orbit of hydrogen is, okay, the radius of nth orbit is given by 52.9 into n square over z, where z is the atomic number. Now for hydrogen anta kottidare, where z is 1, number of protons is 1, n is the first orbit, so n equals 1 we have to put, then radius of the first orbit will be 52.9 divided to 1 square over 1. So it will be 52.9 picometers. See, it is in picometers. So that will be the answer. See, if it is given as helium, then you have to put z equals 2, atomic number 2. And if n is given as some other orbit, you have to substitute corresponding. Second orbit and the n equals 2, third orbit and the n equals 3. Likewise, you can calculate. The energy of an electron, the first Bohr orbit of hydrogen atom. So see, energy of an orbit is given by minus 2.18 into power of minus 18 into z square over n square. See here what happens, as in number of orbit increases, the value decreases. That means it will be less and less strongly bound to the nucleus. So minus sign indicates that it is bound to nucleus, electron is not free. So you can directly substitute the formula if you know this, or you may take it as a comparison if you don't know the value. So that is why it is given here. So we can put z equals 1 and n equals 2 in this, then it becomes 2.18 into power of minus 18 1 over 2 square, that is 4. So if you divide, you are going to get nearly 0.545 10 to the power of minus 18, and then the Selba Alter model, you are going to get this answer. Now you can see this is having higher energy than the first one. So answer for this is, you should know the energy equation for this. 23, number of radial nodes in the 3P density distribution. See, number of nodes is given in, so number of nodes is given as n minus 1, total number of nodes. So there are two types of nodes, that is angular nodes, which is same as L, that will be a plane passing through the origin. So it is a plane passing through origin or the nucleus, whereas the number of radial nodes is given as n minus l minus 1. So here 3p means n equals 3 and p is 1, l value, l is equal to 1. So number of radial nodes will be 3 minus 1 minus 1, that will be 1. That means in the 3p orbital, you find a zero density region here. So here the zero density region will be there. So number of radial nodes will be equal to 1. Number of angular nodes, or L and the HTU, that is equal to 1, where the plane that is passing through the nucleus. So this plane, if you say it is px orbital, then it will be yz plane. So the plane itself will act as the angular node or the zero density region as per the angular part of the wave function. According to radial part of the wave function, it is n minus l minus 1. So how many radial nodes? So the question is about radial nodes, therefore it will be 1. So that will be the answer. So similarly, the question may be asked about anything here. So for say it is about 2s. 2s and n equals 2 agate. So l value will be equal to 0. Then there will be no angular nodes because it is spherical, no angular nodes. Angular nodes, so 0 agate. No angular nodes, 0. Radial nodes will be 2 minus 0 minus 1, that will be 1 once again. So p orbital will be having, 2p orbital will be having a zero density region here. So it is 2 minus L minus 1, L equals 0. So again, there will be a zero density region like this. So it may be asked about any orbital. The speed of an electron in the innermost orbit of hydrogen atom. Innermost of hydrogen atom means we have to consider it as 1. Then we have to apply the formula mvr equals nh over 2 pi. So we are asked about the speed of the electron, velocity of the electron, nh over 2 pi mass of electron under radius. So you are given the radius also, 52.9 picometer. So n equals 1 innermost, 16.626. 10 to the power of minus 34 divided by 2 into 3.14 pi. Mass of electron is 9.11 10 to the power of minus 31 kg multiplied by the value radius 52.9 10 to the power of minus 12. ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಡಿಜಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 6.6, 52.9, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 9 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್. 6 9 so it is 54 ಅದನ್ನ approximately ಇದನ್ನ 9 ಅಂತ ತಗೋಬಹುದು ಇದನ್ನ ಸೊ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ approximation ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಈಜಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ and this may be taken as 3 this may be taken as 9 so this then you group together the powers 10 to the power of minus 34 10 to the power of minus 31 plus 31 shift it to numerator and 10 to the power of plus 12 divided by 2 times 3 and 9 and 9 that's what you can see here so it comes to how much it is minus 3 plus 10 to the power of 9 okay it is 31 12 43 minus 34 it is plus 9 divided by 6 into 81 so it is 10 to the power of 9 divided by almost 48 so now idana sulpa 500 anta enadru approximate maadkondre so this can be taken as say 1000 by 500 into 10 to the power of say 6 500 2 times 2 into 10 to the power of 6 idike close agiro value varuthe nodi idana approximation maadkolde idre ee problem maadadu sulpa kashta agutte so you have to do this type of approximations See what I have done here. I will explain once again. MVR is nh over 2 pi. So we have need the velocity of this. So it is n equals 1 h Planck's constant 2 into 3.14 mass of the electron and radius of first orbit. But now in approximation, what we have done 6.6 in 52.9 can be sub 52 9 times 6 9s of 54 in approximate money. 3.14 na 3 anta maadkoli 9.1 na 9 anta maadkoli then powers of 10 ella meerik shift maadidre we get 10 to the power of 9 so it will be 10 to the power of 9 divided by 2 into 3 9 into 9 so it is 10 to the power of 9 divided by 486 matte illi divide maadoda problem agutte now in 1000 divided by 500 anta approximate maadkotini I'll make this as 500 then 10 to the power of 6 so it will be 2 so 2 into 10 to the power of 6 get close iro answer na unbeku neevu itara approximation maadkolde idre itara problem aglu thumba kashta agutte so 2 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second ge close agiro value b 2.19 and that should be the answer so this is based upon the quantization of the atomic orbitals in the according to Bohr's theory for a given value of principal quantum number the allowed values of n is given as see if n equals 1 then l equals 0 that means there is one value how many values are there the number of allowed values so yav value anta kelta illa what are the values alla how many values are allowed So when you write n equals 2, then we have two values, l equals 0, l and l equals 1. So totally there are two values. So n estirato aste number of values. Therefore, B should be the answer. Number of values of l, azimuthal quantum number, will be same as the number of value of the principal quantum number. 26th question, for a given value of l, the number of allowed values of magnetic quantum number see if you write l equals 0 then l equals 0 that means there is one value if you say l equals 1 there is minus 1 0 and plus 1 there are three values totally how many three values if you put l equals 2 then you are going to write minus 2 minus 1 0 plus 1 plus 2. So totally number of values estirandre It is 2l plus 1 values are there. See if l equals 0, then l it will be 1. If you put l equals 1, then there will be 3 values. If you put l equals 2, there will be 5 values. So if you put l equals 3, then you are going to get 7 value. So 7 total number of magnetic quantum number are possible. Therefore, answer for this will be 2l plus 1. So so many magnetic quantum number values are possible. 27th question, which of the following sets of quantum numbers is not allowed? Okay, here it is based upon the values of magnetic quantum number. Say, consider A, n equals 2, L equals 0 is possible, but M equals plus 1, noting the dot, it will ogle. N equals 2, L equals 1, M is plus 1, possible. When there is L equals 1, you can have the values minus 1, 0, plus 1. So it is allowed. N equals 2 means L may be equal 0 and it may be 1, M equals 0. This is happening. Okay, it's correct. N equals 2, L equals 1, M is minus 1. See, value of L will be less than always the value of N. So D is also correct. So A nalli M equals plus 1 anta kottidare, it is not possible. M take the values from minus L to 0 to plus L. So when N equals 0, M should be 0 only. Therefore, A is not possible and that will be the answer. So that set of quantum numbers is not allowed. Angular quantum number of an electron, of an atomic orbital is governed by. So angular momentum of an electron, it is given by azimuthal quantum number. So it is actually called angular quantum number also. Angular momentum is measured using the value of the azimuthal quantum number. It is given by capital L. So capital L indicates the angular momentum of the electron, where we use the value of L to calculate. So that is azimuthal quantum number. An orbital with L equals 0. Now, L equals 0, it may be 1s or it may be 2s or 3s. So, it will be spherical. It is not oriented along any axis. It is just spherical about the nucleus. Only the size goes on increasing. Therefore, it is symmetrical about the nucleus only. So that will be the answer. Symmetrical about x-axis, right? It is like px orbital. We say px orbital, it is symmetrical about x orbital. Symmetrical about y-axis, it is py orbital, pz orbital. Similarly, if you consider dxy, they are not symmetrical about any axis. They come in between. So whereas dz square orbital is symmetrical about z-axis. So likewise, so L equals 0 means it is S orbital, therefore it is symmetrical about nucleus only. The number of unpaired electrons present in the ground state of chromium. See here, you have to write the electronic configuration. While writing the electronic configuration, you have to apply the rules like Pauli's principle, Hochbauer principle and all that. So you shall go on writing from sorting 1s2, 2s2, say 2p6, then comes 3s2, 3p6, that means 18 electrons are over, so that means it is neon. From neon afterwards we are writing 18, after 18 electrons we are left with, so 6 electrons, then comes 4s2, so 4s2, then it should be how much actually, see it should be 3d4, 1, 2, 3, 4. But what happens when an electron jumps into the 3d orbital, because that becomes half filled, 3d phi configuration. 3d phi configuration has half filled d orbitals, so that gives more stability to the atom. Therefore, outermost electron will, number of outermost electronic configuration will be 4s1, 3d phi. So total number of unpaired electrons is 6. See, 4s also has one unpaired electron. So it comes to 6 electrons and that will be the answer. So you should know that there is an exception in electronic configuration for chromium and copper. with the increase in atomic number, the energy difference between adjacent levels of hydrogen atom, see, as you go away from the nucleus, the distance between the orbitals becomes very close or almost remains constant. With the increase in atomic number, goes on decreasing. So it goes on decreasing, it becomes almost constant at the very far distances. Okay, energy difference adjacent levels of hydrogen may consider it as decreases. So for any atom, as you go away from the nucleus, the distance between the orbits goes on decreasing. Therefore, the energy difference between the orbits goes on decreasing. How many unpaired electrons are present in nickel 2 plus ion? So again, there is Z. So you may start off writing after the 18, that is neon configuration or argon configuration, sorry. This argon configuration will be 4s2. Then after 4s2, you are going to distribute. So 22 electrons are over, you are left with 6 electrons. Then five and six. So totally there are 4 unpaired electrons in the ground state. So in nickel 2 plus ion maadidare andre innerade electron tegidru, we have to remove 2 more electrons. See, these 2 electrons are removed from the s orbital, not from the d orbital. So it becomes 4s0 and then 3d6. So still it has 4 unpaired electrons. See, while putting the electrons, lost electrons are put in d orbital. But while removing, the electrons are removed from 4s. So it is obtained, the facts are obtained from the spectrum of these ions. Therefore, still has 4 unpaired electrons, and that will be the answer. In the previous question, it is, okay, it is not neon, it is argon. Sorry. Which of the following electronic configurations are theoretically not possible? See, n equals 4 means then L will be 0, 1, 2, 3. So it can have S, P, D and F. So it is possible. 3P can exist. See, n equals 3 means L can be equal to 0, 1 and 2. That means S, P, D are possible in third orbit. 2d5 and the quarter is not possible. When n equals 2, you can have L is 0 and 1. That means only s and p orbitals. D orbital irala. Therefore, that will be the answer. 33rd question, D will be the answer. 2d5 cannot exist. Energy of an orbital multi-electron atom is governed by, okay, how many quantum numbers? In a multi-electron system, see, as we go on arranging the electrons, especially in D, we say 4s orbital and 3d are very close to each other. So 3d orbital and 4s are very close to each other. Similarly, even in case of 3s and 3p, 3p will be slightly having higher energy than 3s orbital. Therefore, azimuthal quantum number also matters, whether it is D and also similarly n value. So both n and l values indicate the energy of the orbital for a multi-electron system. Therefore, B will be the answer. See, B, you have to choose. Magnetic quantum number gives only the orientation of the orbital. Spin quantum number refers to the clockwise and anti-clockwise spin. Therefore, that is not the answer. For a D subshell, which of the following quantum number is required? So for a D subshell minimum, see, L equals 0 means S, L equals 1 means P, L equals 2 means it is D, and the value of L will be always less than N. So ninge D varbekandre it should be L equals 2. So for a D subshell, quantum number is always required. Only n equals 3 is more value that is possible. 0, 1, 2, yavadaru irbodu. But l equals 2 is 11. When l equals 2 is there, then it is possible. See, the A cannot be answer because even n equals 4 has D, n equals 5 also has D. So D orbital were vector L must be equal to 2. So which of the electrons are most tightly bound to the nucleus? So though they belong to the same fourth orbit, 4s, 4p, then comes 4d and 4f. So slightly there will be energy difference. That's what we said in the previous question. Both quantum numbers, azimuthal quantum number and principal quantum number, are responsible for the energy of the orbital. They will be penetrated away from the nucleus. See, 4s orbital ether either, 4f orbital will be penetrated very much outside. So like this. Therefore, its energy will be much higher. So 4s orbital will be much tightly, very much tightly bound to the nucleus. It is much closer to nucleus than the others. Whereas other orbitals, they will be projected away from the nucleus. Therefore, most tightly bound to the nucleus is 4s, and that will be the answer. Which of the following atoms would be expected to be most paramagnetic? So paramagnetic property depends upon number of unpaired electrons. So let's imagine that these atoms are isolated. So lithium electronic configuration, one has a 2s1, so one unpaired electron. Nitrogen, 7 atomic number is given, 1s2, 2s2. Then you have to write 2px1, 2p, and the word already, you have to write the expanded electronic configuration. So it is having 3 unpaired electrons. Boron with 5 atomic number, 1s2, 2s2, 2px1. Carbon in the ground state, it has 1s2, 2s2, 2px1 and 2py1. It has got 2 unpaired electrons. So maximum number of unpaired electrons are found in nitrogen. That is expected to be most paramagnetic. Therefore, that will be the answer. So s2 unpaired electrons is at the count body, ground state of the atom, and that will be the answer. Now it is over to the periodic properties, periodic table and classification of the elements. The long form of periodic table is based on the observation made by. See, Lothar Mayer has given the law of octaves, that is every 8th element repeats the property of the first elements. Doberiner is called law of triads, that is atomic mass, atomic number of the middle element is the average of the first element and the third element. So that is law of triads. Mendeleev's, it is based upon atomic weights. Whereas Moseley is the one who proposed on observations of Moseley's experiments, that is square root of the frequency of X-rays emitted is directly proportional to atomic number. So based on this observation, the properties of elements are considered as the functions of atomic numbers. On that basis, the elements are arranged in increasing order of atomic number, and that led to the long form of the periodic table. And so that will be D is the answer. The element with atomic number 2, 10, 18, 36. So all these are what? So the periodic table, the glass one, hydrogen is 1, helium is 2, then comes the lithium and beryllium. So the 2s orbital will be filled, then comes the 2p. So there will be 6 elements with 2p. Then comes, so 2 plus 8 elements. You have to, for the next element, neon, it will be 2 plus 8, it will be 10. Again, next, the orbitals filled will be 3s and 3p. So again, it will be 8. So next element will have the 18 number of electrons, that is 10 plus 8. And next comes the 4s, 3d and 4p. So totally 18 electrons will be added to that. So 18 plus 18 means that will be 36 for the next noble gas. Afterwards, again, you have to add 5s, 4d and 5p, another 18 set. So 36 plus 18, that will be 54 for the next noble gas. And then comes the 4F. So next will be 6S, 6P, 5D and 4F orbital. So 4F, another 14 elements will be added. So totally you have to add 18 plus 14, that is over 32. So next element will be having 54 plus 32, that is 86. So likewise, you can next also we have to add 32 to this 86. So these atomic numbers represent the last group, that is the group 18 elements, noble gases. So noble gases. So atomic number 1 and the light metals or the alkali metals we have chosen. So previous to group or 17 group are the halogen, the rare earths are the radioactive elements that is found in the F block. So noble gases is the answer for this question. Select the wrong statement with respect to halogens. So we shall see about the properties. They have an electronic configuration of 7 valence electrons, that is correct, that is NS2, NP5. So the statement is correct. They are highly electropositive, actually that is wrong. They are most electronegative elements. So that should be the wrong statement. They show variable oxidation state of minus 1 to plus 7. What is the fluorine ke apply agala, except fluorine. So you can generally say chlorine, bromine, iodine, they exhibit this. So it can be taken, okay, there is an exception for fluorine. Forms volatile and covalent hydrogen halides like HCl, HF. They are volatile. Usually they are gases or they are volatile. Means they having very low boiling points. Therefore, with an oxidation state of minus, and that is also correct. So B is the statement that is wrong with respect to halogens. They are electronegative, not electropositive. Electropositives are the metals which give away one electron easily. Which of the following has largest atomic radius? See, hydrogen must be bigger when comes the helium. Then lithium must be bigger than hydrogen because it is having an extra shell. So potassium comes very much later with many shells. So potassium is much bigger. So potassium must be having highest atomic radius. So D should be the answer. Which of the following property of alkaline earth metals increases with atomic number? So alkaline earth metals, it starts from beryllium, then magnesium, calcium, strontium and barium. So atomic size goes on increasing. No doubt about it, atomic size goes on increasing. Ionization goes on, energy goes on decreasing. See, as the new orbital is added, effective atomic number decreases. Therefore, the hold of the nucleus on the valence electron decreases. Ionization energy decreases. Atomic size increases. Solubility of the sulfates actually that decreases down the group. So barium sulfate precipitate, if you have seen, you can easily remember it is less soluble, whereas magnesium sulfate is soluble in water, highly soluble. Barium sulfate and calcium sulfate are less soluble. Electronegativity goes on decreasing. Actually, they are metals. So even if they have electronegativity, that goes on decreasing. Therefore, that property that increases down the group of the alkaline earth metals, the increase in atomic number and right down the group at the top of the group. So that is atomic size, and that will be the answer for it. That is the only property that goes on increasing. Next question is, which pair of atomic numbers represents elements both P block? Okay, 4 and 8. See, first is hydrogen with atomic number 1. First period we have got hydrogen atomic number 1. Then we have got helium with atomic number 2. Okay, then second period we have got atomic number 2, 3, 4, that is lithium, beryllium, then comes 5, boron, carbon 6, nitrogen 7, oxygen 8, fluorine 9 atomic number, and then neon with 10. So 4 and 8 and the kotidare, 4 and 8 refers to beryllium and oxygen. So A allali. So 8 and 16, so we have to write further. Then comes sodium, the atomic number 11, then magnesium with 12, then aluminium with 13 atomic number, aluminium, then silicon 14, phosphorus 15, sulfur 16, and then halogen chlorine with 17, then argon. So let's see, 8 and 16. See, 8 is oxygen, 16 is sulfur. They both elements belong to P block. 6 and 12 are there. Okay, 6 is carbon. So 6 is carbon. 12 means it is magnesium. So second one is magnesium. Therefore, that is not the pair belonging to P block. 10 and 20. 10 and then neon and tagate. So 20 will be belong. That is the next element that comes, calcium after potassium. So 10 is neon, minus 20 is calcium, will belong to the S block. So both elements belong into P block, and 8 and 16. So we must be familiar with the structure of the periodic table to answer this type of questions. Which one of the following has the smallest size? See, nitrogen is 7 atomic number plus 3 electrons, and the say that it has got 7 protons and 10 electrons. Oxygen has 8 protons and 10 electrons, oxide ion, 10 electrons. So the proton number jaasti agide, therefore the atomic size should be decreasing. Fluoride is having 9 protons and 10 electrons. So that should be further small compared to oxide. Sodium has 11 protons and 10 electrons. See, these are known as isoelectronic species. So these are the ions having same number of electrons. Number of protons jaasti than their effective atomic number will be very high. So it will be strongly holding the nucleus. Ellanu 10 electron, they are having the same number of orbits, same orbits. So as the effective number, atomic number increases, the nuclear force of attraction increases. So the atomic sizes correspondingly is decreasing. So this will be A, B, C and D. So smallest atom will be sodium ion. So atomic numbers and concept of isoelectronic species, on that this question is based. So this will be the answer, sodium. Question number 8, which of the following represents correct order of the radii? Okay, we have to check everyone. A, hydride is anion, that should be greater than actually hydrogen ground state and then H plus. So A sariya kottiladu. Cation is smaller than the atom and anion is bigger than the atom. Na plus F minus O2 minus. So just now we saw in the previous question, sodium plus has 11 protons, 10 electrons. F minus has 9 protons and 10 electrons. And then oxide has 8 protons and 10 electrons. So this is appearing to be correct. Let's see if there are many answers. F minus O minus could be Na plus, and it should be wrong because this will be having O minus till the order tappu agide, therefore C will be wrong. Let's see about the next one. So there may be multiple answers, that is correct. Aluminium has 13 protons and 10 electrons, that will be smaller than magnesium. See, magnesium has 12 protons and 10 electrons, so that is also correct. 13 protons, 12 protons, so it should be smaller than magnesium. Magnesium is smaller than nitride and the kotidare. Let's see that it is correct. So nitride and then nitrogen is having 7 protons and 10 electrons. So 7 protons, that will be bigger. So here it is smallest, highest nuclear force. So least nuclear force. So D kuda correct agide. So there are two answers that is correct in this question. B and D. See, both are correct. So, eradu correct answers. See, the kelavu exams alli itara keltare, then you will be having some more options like A is correct, B is correct, both B and D are correct. Athara innandashtu options na kottirtare. So, both are correct. So, there are two correct answers in this. Ionic radii of the halide ions are found to be greater than the corresponding radii. So, X minus is bigger than X. Any negative recharged ion will be bigger than its parent atom because of increasing number of protons. Because number of protons will be same. So, if you consider F minus and F, both are having same number of protons. Increasing number of neutrons, it is not electron addition is not going to affect the structure of the nucleus. Decrease in shielding effect. Shielding effect actually increase. Shielding, as you go on adding the electron, the shielding effect E should increase. Therefore, it should become loosely held. So, increase in shielding effect. Decrease actually increase. Decrease in atomic number. Atomic number is not going to decrease. So, we have to consider which answer. The shielding effect almost remains same, so that cannot be the answer because electron is added to the same orbit, that is 2p or 3p like that. So shielding effect due to inner electrons remains almost same. No decrease in atomic number is there, and then an answer for chain one, decrease in effective atomic number. So as effective atomic number, number of electrons, protons holding the number of electrons will be same. Therefore, that should be the answer. Halides ions are having greater size because of decreasing effective atomic number. Z effective is going to decrease. Therefore, D should be the answer. So, most suitable answer is decreasing atomic number. That's all chain one. Decreasing effective atomic number. The correct order of first ionization energy of sodium, magnesium, aluminium and silicon. Okay, so sodium outermost electronic configuration is S1. If you remove an electron, it will attain the previous noble gas configuration. So it will attain the noble gas configuration, neon configuration, if it loses one electron. So it will lose an electron very easily. For magnesium to get one ion, electron removed, it is smaller than sodium. So, ionization energy of magnesium must be greater than that of sodium. See, sodium normally magnesium varudhu, so size kadma agudhu. So, magnesium ionization energy is greater than that of sodium. For aluminium, what happens? The electron is removed from 3p orbital. So, it is little bit away from the nucleus. So, magnesium is easy agi electron aluminium da tegibodu. So, aluminium must be having lesser ionization energy than magnesium. Next comes the silicon with 3s, 3p x1 and 3p y1. Now, what happens? The removal of electron becomes difficult because of the decreasing size. Aluminium is bigger than silicon. Silicon has the smaller size because it's the increase in nuclear charge. Therefore, that will be strongly holding the valence electron. So, silicon will have higher ionization energy than aluminium. So, the best suitable answer will be sodium less than magnesium. Should be like this. Sodium less than magnesium because of the size. Magnesium greater than aluminium because it is electron removed from 3p orbital. Higher energy, and aluminium is smaller than silicon. So that will be the answer. The answer na select mode. 10th one is the answer. So there generally we say along the period the atomic size decreases, but removal of the electron also matters from which orbital you are removing, 3s or 3p like that. Among the following elements, the electronic configurations are given. Which of the following has highest ionization energy? See, all are p block elements. Actually, first one is boron, this is carbon, and this is nitrogen, this is oxygen. where nitrogen has half filled 3p orbital, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1. Therefore, for nitrogen, there will be highest ionization energy. If you draw the graph, you'll understand. For boron, if it is like this, for carbon, it increases because size decreases. For nitrogen, it will be very high because of 3p3 electronic configuration, then decreases for oxygen. So nitrogen is having highest ionization energy. So it is one of the exceptional cases and also general trend in the periodic table. So nitrogen has highest ionization energy, therefore that will be the answer. Successive ionization energy of the element is given in kilojoule. So you shall imagine that it is in kilojoule per mole, 740. So X to become, say, X plus, you have to spend 740 kilojoule. To make it X2 plus, see, where there is a very huge amount of energy required. That means to remove the electron from the next electron, you have to spend very high amount of the energy. The difference is very high. So X plus is very much stable. To produce X2 plus, it is difficult. You have to spend 15,000 kilojoule of energy. Difference is very large. Therefore, it will settle to the X plus. That will be the best possible answer. Then around 2,000-3,000 koti, next we could have gone to the next stage. Hogodaitu it ionize agutte anta, but here second ionization energy IE2 is very much greater than IE1. So value compare madidre gotagutide. Therefore you can say that but X2 plus iradana X3 plus madodu easy, because the energy difference is very small once again. So formation of X plus is easier than the other ions. So X plus ion, now choose Markov. That should be the answer. Which of the following is weakest base? See, basic property decreases along a period. First of all, that should be kept in mind. Along a period, the basic property goes on decreasing. Initially, S block elements are basic, then we get amphoteric substances in the middle, that is in the D block, which will react with both acid and base. And then it comes to the P block, where it may be acidic properties will increase. So basic and the sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide must be basic. Zinc hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, zinc hydroxide is amphoteric substance in fact. So it can react with both acid and a base. Therefore, that should be the answer. Weakest base among the following are the zinc hydroxide. But if you consider down the groups, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, and then calcium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide must be the strongest base among the given. It's only theoretical. If you dissolve them, all of them may exhibit a pH of 14. So theoretically speaking, down the group, basic nature increases. What is the correct order of electronegativity of the four elements, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur and phosphorus? See, if you know the periodic table, you can say carbon, nitrogen, silicon and phosphorus like this. So sizes, carbon will be smaller, carbon is bigger than nitrogen, similarly phosphorus is bigger than silicon. Now down the group, atomic size increases, therefore electronegativity decreases. Silicon must be less electronegative than phosphorus. Phosphorus must be less electronegative than carbon because of the size, and then comes nitrogen. So that order. So you have to compare down the group and also across the period of the elements given. So C should be the answer. Silicon less than phosphorus, less than carbon and nitrogen. This question is very much frequently asked in the competitive examinations. Which of the following elements are likely to have zero electron gain enthalpy? See, radium is the radioactive element that comes in the alkali metals. Phosphorus comes in the nitrogen group. Oxygen comes in the chalcogens, that is the 16th group of the element. This is 15th group, this is the first group of the elements. Electron gain enthalpy will be zero when it is very difficult to add the electron. Phosphorus can gain the electrons, oxygen can gain the electrons, radium loses the electron. Therefore, it is best answer among the following is a noble gas. See, noble gases do not accept the electron easily. Therefore, they cannot form anions. They are nearly zero, almost zero electron gain enthalpy will be for a noble gas. So, usually helium, neon, argon, yavad answer choose mark. Correct order of decreasing electron gain enthalpy of halogens. See this, actually fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, that is the order. And if you compare the sizes, the atomic size goes on increasing. Generally, electron gain enthalpy goes on decreasing the group and the now healthy. It increases across the period and decreases down the group. It is a general trend. But one problem with the halogen is to add an electron to fluorine to get fluoride is difficult because fluorine is a very small atom. So 2p orbitals are very small. They are very close to each other. So already electrons that are present will repel the new electron. The sixth electron for the 2p orbital will be repelled because of too small size of the 2p orbitals and also fluorine atom. Hagagi chlorine electron gain enthalpy jaasti barutte. See, you should not confuse this with electronegativity. Electronegativity ge order sari hogutte. Fluorine has highest electronegativity. But for electron gain enthalpy, how much energy is released when you add an electron to the gaseous atom, and chlorine will be highest, then comes fluorine and then bromine and iodine. Therefore, C will be the answer. So, C should be the answer. A property which decreases down the group is electron gain enthalpy goes on increases. Okay, it increases down the group. Is the size of the atom, it is generally it is there, and that is electron gain enthalpy decreases. So as you go down the group, the distance between the nucleus and the new electron goes on decreasing, and there will be shielding effect also. So new electron experiences more repulsions, so repulsions koda jaasti agutte, shielding effect jaasti agutte, electron gain enthalpy decreases down a group. Ionization enthalpy also decreases. It will be easier to remove the valence electron to get the positively charged ion because it will be loosely bound to the nucleus. Size of the atom increases. So size of the atom jaasti agutte, and also metallic character, no, idu observe maadi, metallic character also increases. So there are two answers here. Both B and D are answers for it. So there is multiple answer here. There are two properties that increase around the group. Metallic character refers to losing the electron very easily, and also appearance of shining nature. You might have seen iodine crystals, it has got shining nature, it is because of some free electrons in it. So it can form easily I3 plus like ion in form. Therefore, metallic character refers to availability of free electrons. An electron will be freed from the valence orbital if it is loosely bound. Therefore, as the atomic size increases, removal of electrons, outermost electron becomes easy. Therefore, metallic character increases. So, there are two properties here which increase down the group, that is B and also D. So, there will be more options given to you. Both B and D are correct answers for this. Okay, that's all for periodic table and atomic structure. Okay, thank you for this. So there is one question in which there is a correction to be made, that is effective atomic number in case of the fluorine question. So that I have referred. So he is making a correction here in this question. So this question, so last option will be decrease in effective atomic number. Not just atomic number, it is decrease in effective atomic number, that should be D and that will be the answer. Okay, thank you.